Welcome as we pause in this time of reflection. As we do so, I acknowledge the Ngunnawal, Ngambri and Ngarrigu as the first peoples and traditional custodians across the region we today know as Canberra. The church has long adopted the language of kingdom when describing the nature of God's realm. It's language which comes from Jesus himself. Yet often when describing that which he called the kingdom, Jesus also used imagery of gardening. In the tension of these images held together, we gain a deeper insight into what it means to be the people of God, expressing in our lives God's commonwealth of peace. For a time, our son lived near the town of Wodonga. In case you don't know, Wodonga is one of the twin towns, Albury and Wodonga, which lie on each side of the New South Wales-Victorian border. Wodonga is the town on the Victorian side, and it's interestingly, if you want to phone a number in Wodonga, you need to use an 02 prefix, which in fact is the prefix for New South Wales. Okay. So that's not a big issue, but it is one of the features of what it means to be a border town. I remember spending a night there some years ago, and in the mornings I was listening to the radio program. One of the issues of discussion was the fact that there are a number of children who would go to school to primary school in one state, but then do high school in another state. And that created all sorts of issues as their education was across two different educational systems. Being a border people means that there is interaction and effect. Your life as a people is shaped by what goes on beyond the border, just as you shape that which is going on the other side. The implications for a place like Albury Wodonga are relatively mild. They are much, much greater for borders between countries where there are different cultures, languages, and legal systems. I mention this stuff because there is a sense in which those who are followers of Christ are called to be a border people, and possibly even a people who live beyond their own border. We hold a sense of identity, of being a people of God's realm. And yet we live in the midst of the societies of this world. Now, that doesn't mean that we exist in some sort of isolated bubble which protects us from any sort of interaction and that we should keep ourselves apart. To the contrary, we are called to dwell in the midst of the community in which we live, in full awareness of the interactions that exist. How we are impacted by what goes on around us and how we may impact that the world around us. So this is what it means to be a missional people, to recognize that we are a border people, citizens of God's commonwealth of peace, living in the midst of a society where often anything but the idea of God's peace calls the shots. It is also to me the point of the parable of the wheat and the weeds, which we discover in Matthew chapter 13. We are continuing on with the series of parables that Jesus told, and we began hearing those last week regarding parables of the kingdom. He put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seed in his field. But while everybody was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared as well. And the slaves of the householder came and said to him, "Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from?" He answered, "An enemy has done this." The slave said to him, "Then do you want us to go and gather them?" But he replied, No, for in gathering the weeds, you would uproot the wheat along with them. Let both of them grow together unto the harvest, and at the harvest time I will tell the reapers, collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burnt, but gather the wheat into my barn. Then he left the crowds and went into the house, and his disciples approached him, saying, explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field. He answered, the one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed are the children of the kingdom. The weeds, the children of the evil one. And the enemy has sown them, who has sown them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burnt up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all evildoers, and they'll throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let anyone with ears listen. In one way, the parable is a warning against the arrogance of assuming you have the right or even the ability to distinguish between the righteous and the unrighteous, and the dangers and inappropriateness of practices of inclusion and exclusion. But the parable also reminds us that to separate one from the other misses the function of the wheat to produce and spread seeds of love and compassion, seeds of hope and vision, seeds of the kingdom. As followers of Jesus, our calling is to be wheat among the weeds, the citizens of God's commonwealth living as border people. We are agents of the kingdom, living out its new way of being that Christ calls us to. But what does that mean for us on the ground in day-to-day life? It is to respond to the struggle with compassion, to seek to be agents of justice and peace in the midst of turmoil, and to express the love of God and the hope we have in Christ equally to everyone. In truth, we are a people of two cultures, without doubt shaped and reflecting the surrounding community within which we live, but called to impact the community as agents of the kingdom. Wheat shedding seeds of love, peace, justice, and hope.
See.
Let's pray. Light of the nations, sight of the blinded, you are our freedom from every dark prison. In the moments of comfort, liberation, healing, hope and inspiration which touch our lives, in the compassionate impulse and the yearning for justice and peace which inspires us to action, in the faith we have in you, which shapes our lives and calls us to follow your way. Shine your light on the world. Shine your light in and through us. Amen. In you have the seeds of Christ's words been planted. You are heralds of hope, ministers of compassion, agents of change. May the love lifted high upon the cross burst forth in your living as a people following in the way of Christ, and may you know the blessing of God now and always. Amen.